This is a story. Are you ready for a story? Have you ever experienced a dramatic internal struggle within you where you ask yourself, what am I doing? In college, I experienced that struggle. You see, I went to a party school and I had friends who knew where all the parties were at. We celebrated Tequila Tuesdays, Wasted Wednesdays, and Thirsty Thursdays. And you know, Friday and Saturday, we just set that aside for whatever party we heard about. When you're an introvert and kind of a nerd, it's really hard to make friends. It's hard to feel accepted. It's hard to feel like you belong. I had a car in college so I could drive my friends to the parties, and in exchange for a ride, I was invited to the party. That's where I made my friends, through those parties. That is how I felt accepted. That is where I seemed to belong. And during my party days, I never had so many friends. But belonging, having friends, and partying doesn't cause a long-lasting happiness. I soon realized that I was missing something in life. There was a void. Even though I thought I was doing all the things a 19-year-old in college could do to find happiness. But where was it? I started going to church thinking that I could find that happiness. I told God that I wanted Him to change my life, and in exchange I would follow Him. I told Him that I would pray and I would read my Bible. I told Him that I would stop partying, stop drinking, and stop hanging out with the bad crowd. When I did all of that, I thought I would finally find happiness. But I was wrong. I didn't find happiness in church. And one night, in my room, I sat in my chair and I thought, what am I doing? Why did I give up a fun party lifestyle? Why wasn't I finding happiness in the church? And I yelled at God. I asked Him why nothing had changed and why I still felt an emptiness in my life. Then it hit me. I only changed my outward actions, but inside, I was still that introverted, shy kid who wanted to keep control of his life. God convicted me, and I knew that I had to give complete control of my life to God. I knew that only in Him could I find true happiness and joy. Only in Him could I experience the fullness of life. So I prayed. I remembered a Bible verse, and I grabbed my Bible and I turned to Psalm 51. I read it as my prayer. Have mercy on me, O God, because of your unfailing love, because of your great compassion. Blot out the stain of my sins. Purify me from my sins, and I will be clean. Wash me, and I will be whiter than snow. Oh, give me back my joy again. I asked God to forgive me for all the bad things I had done in my life. I asked God to come into my life and be my God. I asked Him to help me find happiness. And through the tears, through the prayers, I felt something. Something within me changed. That emptiness that I had previously felt was gone. I felt filled with something. And the only way that I can describe it is to say that it was a warm wholeness within me. Since this encounter with God, nothing has been the same. And I'm glad about that. My name is Joshua Hamilton, and God has brought joy into my life. What will He do for you?